Hey you guys, Awakened Gaming here again with another Hack the Box tutorial. So today we are going to be doing Legacy. And if we click in here, we can see that this is a Windows machine and we're going to be dealing with a CVE. The difficulty is piece of cake and our IP address is 10.10.10.4. So let's go ahead and get connected to our VPN so we can see to where you downloaded that OVPN file in one of the previous videos. And if you don't know what's going on, I'm going to leave an iCard here so that way you can go back and revisit the videos and see how to get all of that stuff started. So then we type open VPN and then your username and then .ovpn, and as we can see our initialization sequence was completed, so we can right click this and move this to another desktop. We can open up a new terminal and we're going to go ahead and ping that IP address just to make sure that we're connected. So 10.10.10.4, and we can see we are receiving data, so we'll control Z to stop that and clear the screen. Now we can start up our nmap, so nmap-sc-sv, that's for our safe scripts and our service information and service version number, and then it was 10.10.10.4, and we'll go ahead and get that started, and let's see if there is a website attached, 10.10.10.4. And it does appear that there could potentially be one. It looks like it might be trying to connect. So while this is happening and our nmap scan is going, I would like to take a moment and talk with you guys. So on my previous video, I've already got over 1,700 views. I've gained a boatload of subscribers from 40 to over 100, I think it's closer towards 110 at this point. You guys have left me some amazing comments. I've got a lot of likes on the video, and so you guys have just been showing me overwhelmingly positive reviews, so I wanted to take a couple of minutes to tell you guys how much I appreciate that. Thank you guys so very much for that. That is honestly, it's wild. So again, thank you guys so much. That positive reviews and all the positive feedback and subscribers and stuff lets me know that you guys really, really like this video, like the type of content that I'm putting out. So with that being said, thank you guys so much. And let's see if the nmap has finished, and it has. So we can see we have three ports here. This guy is closed. We learned from last video that this is SMB, and here's a net BIOS port, and we can see that the SMB server is leaking the name of the computer, the work group of the computer, the system time, and the SMB security mode is guest, and authentication level is user again. And message signing is disabled. So with that being said, let us see if we can't find, and this failed, so let us see if we can't find the CVE for this. Da 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 da. Looks like they've got the same port open here. And da 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 da. Let's see what exploit they use here. And they use this exploit here. So let's go ahead and see if that works for us. I believe it will. So let's go ahead and open up another window. And we can MFS DB start, and then we'll MSF console, console, and we should be able to use that exploit. That looks like it should work. It was targeting the exact same service as before, or as we were seeing use. So we'll just right click and paste clipboard and show options. And we need to set the R host. So set R host to 10.10.10.4 and show options again. And we have that set to automatic targeting, so we can go ahead and run exploit and see if this works. It should. And there we go, we get our metasploit shell. And so I'm going to go ahead and explain kind of what this is and how it works. So basically, there's quite a bit of older Windows OS's that are affected by this. Windows 2000, Service Pack 4, XP Service Pack 2, Service Pack 3, Windows Server 2003, Service Pack 1 and Service Pack 2, Vista Gold, Service Pack 2, just a lot of them, all the way up through Windows Server 2008 and Windows 7 pre-beta. And basically it lets us execute arbitrary code via a crafted RCP or RPC request, rather, that triggers an overflow and grants us access. So here we can see that it starts up that reverse TCP handler for us. It automatically detects the target as Windows XP Service Pack 3, and then it attempts to trigger the vulnerability. It sends the stager and then opens up the metasploit shell and directs it back to us on that TCP handler that it set up. So if we type shell and then who am I, we can see our what's the command for that? Give me just 1 second to remember. I think it's GUID. Yeah, that's it. Okay. We can see that we are authority. And if we go back into our shell, we can run IP config. And we can see that we are connected to the box. So if we cd ./ a bunch, we can get back down to the root folder, dir, and we can see that we can go into documents, so cd documents and settings. And we have the user administrator and the user John, so we can cd into admin. DIR. We can cd to desktop. And we can see our root.txt there. And then we can also cd to John, I think it was. Pretty sure that's what it was. Let's go back up here. Yep, John. / desktop. DIR again. And we get our users.txt file. And remember, I'm just going to go ahead and show you guys the one for John right quick, just to show you guys how to get into it. Some people were commenting that they couldn't get into it, so you would type in more. user.txt, and that's how you would get the file. I believe in the last video I accidentally said less, it's actually more. So all you would do is you would take this, you would right click, copy the selection, come back over here to here. You guys could just do it from that page using own user and own root right here. Hang on, let me get back into it. You could just click own root, own user right there and be able to do it. Or you can come out here and click on the submit flag, paste this in, and then you can select the difficulty you thought it was. And we can submit the flag, error user already owned, so it's not going to let me re-own it, of course, already own it. But that is how you actually complete that. So this was another really quick, easy box. On the next box, which I'll actually be putting that video out within an hour or two of this video, we will actually get into some actual exploits. We'll be exploiting an FTP server, and then we'll have to use some privilege escalation in order to get from user to root, I'm pretty sure. So that one will be a little bit more challenging. I'm pretty sure there's the privilege escalation. I'm not 100% sure about that. I don't quite recall, but if you did like this video, please consider subscribing. And like I said, I will be putting another one out in a couple of hours after this video goes live. So if you want to stay tuned for that, make sure you hit the notification bell as well, so that way you can be alerted when that one comes out. Appreciate you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in a couple of hours.